developed here on Monday Night Raw in Anaheim. Mr. McMahon, his daughter Stephanie in the ring. All the superstars from the WWE locker room have been filed out on stage, and there is the man of the hour if you're Randy Orton. His name is Triple H. He is the special guest referee from last night's SummerSlam, and he's the man who pedigreed Daniel Bryan. After Bryan won the WWE Championship, literally handing the title to Randy Orton, who cashed in Money in the Bank. It looks like the Shield is
giving up for the game!
Running security.
And the game looks mighty proud of himself, actually.
What a wonderful night. What a momentous occasion. The coronation of a new WWE champion, a champion we can all be proud of. And I must say, tonight I am most proud of my son-in-law. I had my doubts, but in the end, you did the right thing. In the end, you saw the light.
Oh, man.
Yes!
So I guess this is where I'm supposed to explain myself to all of you, right? As you put it, why I would throw away the future, why I would screw Daniel Bryan. It always makes me laugh how short-sighted all of you are. You can never see the bigger picture. I did what I did last night to ensure the future of the WWE. I did what I did last night for all of you. I did what I did for each and every one of you. I did it for you. I did it for you. I did it for all of your children. I did it for their children. I did it for all of you standing up on top of that ramp. I did it for Vince McMahon. I did it for his grandfather, Jess McMahon, for his father, Vince Sr., and for Vince McMahon, the genius that created this global empire that you all enjoy today. I did it for him so that this will be here long after he is gone. I did this for my wife and our children so that this will exist in their future. I did this for each and every one of you in the WWE universe, so this WWE will continue to exist in all of your futures. You think I wanted to do that to Daniel Bryan? Hell, I like Daniel Bryan. I consider Daniel Bryan to be a friend. I like what he does in this ring. I'm a big fan of Daniel Bryan's. Daniel Bryan is a very good little technician. And he gave John Cena one hell of a match last night. And he deserved to win. But let's be honest. WWE champion, face of the WWE, no, you deserve better than that. Each and every one of you in this arena watching around the world deserve better than that. You deserve the complete package. You deserve somebody that has it all. You deserve A+, not B. Don't ever settle for less. You deserve A+, and that is what I gave you last night. I gave you A+. And Daniel Bryan comes out here and says he has a personal problem with that. That's a sacrifice I'm willing to make. Daniel Bryan's personal problem? What about my personal issues? You think, let's put this on me for a second. Forget Daniel Bryan. How did I feel about this personally? You think personally I wanted to do that to Daniel Bryan? You think I wanted to throw away Daniel Bryan's 15 years of blood, sweat, and tears to get to where he was last night? You think I wanted to throw that all away because he overachieved? No, I didn't. It hurt me. It hurt me personally to do that to Daniel Bryan. And let's look at the guy that I did it with. Let's look at the new WWE champion. You think I liked doing that with him? Hell no. There is no love loss between he and I. There is a lot of bad blood, a lot of water under that bridge, but I buried my personal feelings. I buried my personal feelings for what was right for you. I buried all that. I buried all that hate and bitter feelings. I buried all of it to do what was right for each and every one of you. And quite frankly, for Daniel Bryan to stand out here and say he had a personal problem with it, I don't really care about his personal problems. And to be quite honest, Daniel, you saying that you have a personal problem with this is just selfish. Plain and simple, selfish, Daniel. This is not all about you. Daniel Bryan, you need to check your ego at the door, pal. Just like I do mine every week when I go to work. It's not about me. It's not about what I do. It's about the WWE Universe. You put your personal feelings aside and you do what is right for business. And right now, I am gonna do what needs to be done, and I am gonna put aside my personal feelings one more time, and I am gonna bring out here right now the future, your future, the face of the WWE, the coal that has now become the diamond. I give you the new WWE Champion, the Viper, Randy Orton!
I hear voices in my head. They count to me. They understand. They talk to me.
You got your now, there's the man who cashed in his Money in the Bank briefcase, his contract last night at SummerSlam on Daniel Bryan. After Bryan had defeated John Cena to win the title, Triple H, the special guest referee, hit Bryan with a pedigree. But what about you, King? But I never thought that I'd hear that type of explanation out of Triple H. Much like Daniel Bryan said earlier, that's something I would have expected to have heard out of Mr. McMahon or even Stephanie, but Triple H? A man who's held the world championship over a dozen times and understands the importance of being a champion, how hard you get there.
Well, you're right. Let's get one thing straight. I don't know if anyone has a problem with Randy Orton being WWE champion. He's certainly capable. He's incredible. He's great for the face of the WWE. It's just the way it was done, the way it happened. Triple H was more responsible for it than Randy Orton.
That's the precedent that I think a lot of people have a problem with.
Man,
what a nice moment.
That's putting the past behind you. Randy Orton has done to that young woman over the years.
To put the past behind you and do what's right for business. How great is Triple H?
I told you so. I told you that when I cashed in, you would not see it coming. And now here I stand before you for the 10th time, the apex predator of the WWE. Now, I'm not usually one for thank yous, but in this case, I think I could make an exception. After what you did last night for me, Triple H, well, I'm not ashamed to say it. I owe all of this to you. As a matter of fact, everyone in this arena should stand up on their feet and show this man the respect that he deserves.
Now, since we own the place, we have eyes and ears everywhere, and I know that Daniel Bryan is in this building. So here's the thing, Daniel. I know you have a personal issue with this, and I want to get it out in the open like men. So I'm offering to you to come to this ring right now. Stand in the ring with me. Look me eye to eye. Get it all off your chest, Daniel. You can come out here, have yourself a good cry. Whatever you feel like you need to do to get past this so that you can move on with your little career. So, Daniel, come on out, wherever you are. You know what? Hold on. Shield guys, Ambrose, Reigns, Rollins, can you do me a favor? You guys are a little intimidating. He's probably scared. You guys mind moving to the side? I don't want anybody touching Daniel Bryan. Anybody on that stage gets involved, touches Daniel Bryan, there's going to be problems. That includes you. Daniel Bryan, come on out, wherever you are. That's a good idea, Vince. Let's make Daniel feel at home. Who wants to see Daniel Bryan? Do you want to see Daniel Bryan? Yes. Yes. Yes, 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 let's play his music. Let's play his music. Let's make Daniel feel at home. Come on, Daniel.
We're waiting for Daniel Bryan. Here's his chance. Not for nothing, but you can't blame the guy if he doesn't come out here.
There he is.
Yes.
problems if they win it.
Look at Daniel Bryan trying to fight out of this thing. Daniel Bryan trying to fight away from the Shield here. And now Ambrose and Bryan trying to get to the ring.
Oh, man. And Bryan's still taking it too.
Let's talk about this. Get your feelings out. Come on.
Oh, no.
It's
again the Shield. This is ridiculous.
No. Hold on. Put him down. Stop. It's not what I want. Daniel Bryan clearly has something to say. Daniel, let him come in the ring and say it. Daniel, you want to come in here? You want to come in? Come on, say it. Come on, get it off your chest. Come on, Daniel, you can do it. Come on. Show some guts. Come on. That's it. Come on. That's that fighting spirit. Come on. You got it. That's it. Come on. Come on, fight. Fight for it. Come on. Come on, let's talk. Let's talk, you and I, man to man. Come on, Daniel, that's it. Show me those guts. Come on, that's it. Dig down. You got it.
Oh, no! Are you kidding me? Orton with an RKO? Just as Daniel Bryan was getting into the ring.
And after all the dirty work had been done by the Shield. Well, there you go. The McMahons and Triple H have their man.